myself. Listen to my people, to my instruction, incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will move my mouth in a parable, I will utter dark sins of old, which we have heard alone, and our fathers have told us, we will not conceal them from their children, but tell to the generations to come, the praises of the Lord and his strength, and his wondrous works that he has done. For he established a testimony in Jacob, and appointed a law in Israel, which he commanded our fathers that they should teach them to the children, that the generation to come might know, even the children yet to be born, that they may arise and tell them to the children, that they should put their confidence in God, and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments, and not be like their fathers, a stubborn and rebellious generation, a generation that did not prepare its heart, when the spirit was not faithful to God. The sons of Ephraim were archers, people with bows. Yet they turned back in the day of battle. They did not keep the covenant of God and refused to walk in his law. They forgot his deeds and his miracles that he had shown them. He wrought wonders before the fathers in the land of Egypt. In the fields of Soman, he divided the sea and parted the Red Sea. He made the water stand up like a heap. Then he led them with a cloud by day and all the night with a light of fire. He split the rocks in the wilderness and gave them abundant drink like the ocean depths. He brought forth streams also from the rock and caused waters to run down like rivers. But they still continued to sin against him, to rebel against the Most High in the desert. And in their heart, they put God to the test by asking food according to their desire. Then they spoke against God. They said, can God prepare a table in the wilderness? Behold, he struck the rock so that waters rushed out and streams were overflowing. Can he give bread also? Will he provide meat for his people? Therefore, the Lord heard and was full of wrath, and the fire was kindled against Jacob, and the anger also mounted against Israel, because they did not believe in God and did not trust in his salvation. Yet he commanded the clouds above and opened the doors of heaven, and rained down manna upon them to eat, and gave them food from heaven. Man did eat the bread of angels. He sent them food in abundance. He caused the east wind to blow in the heavens, and by his power he directed the south wind. When he rained meat upon them like to dust, even wind fouled like the sands of the seas. Then he let them fall in the midst of a camp round about their dwellings. So they ate and were well filled in the desire he gave to them, before they had satisfied their desire, while the food was still in their mouths. The anger of God rose against them and killed some of those thousands once, and subdued the choice of men of Israel. In spite of all this, they still sin and did not believe in his wonderful works. So he brought their days to an end in futility, and their years in sudden terror, when he killed them. Then he sought him and returned and searched diligently for God, and they remembered that God was the rock and the Most High God, their redeemer. But they deceived him with their mouth and lied to him with their tongue, for their heart was not steadfast toward him, nor were they faithful to his covenant. But being compassionate, forgave their iniquity and did not destroy them, and often he restrained his anger and did not arouse all his wrath. Thus he remembered that they were but flesh, a wind that passes and does not return. How often they rebelled against him in the wilderness, and reached him in the desert. Again and again they tempted God and came to Holy One of Israel. They did not remember his power, the days when he redeemed them from the adversary, when he performed his signs in Egypt, when his mouth was in the field of Zoan, and from the rivers to blood, and the streams they cannot drink. He sent among them a swarm of flies, which devoured them, and frogs, which destroyed them. He gave also the crops of the grasshopper, and the product of their labor to the locusts. He destroyed their vines with hailstones, and their sycamore trees with frost. He gave over their cattle also to the hailstones, and the boats to the bolts of lightnings. And he sent upon them his burning anger, fury and indignation and trouble, a band of destroying angels. He never laid path for his anger. He did not spare the soul from death, but gave over their life to the plague, and smote all the firstborn of Egypt, the first issue of the D-I-R-I-L-I-T-Y in the tents of men. For he led forth his people like sheep, and guided them in the wilderness like a flock. He led them safely, so that they did not fear, but as he engulfed their enemies, so he brought them to his holy land, to his whole country, which his right hand had gained. He also placed all the nations before them, and apportioned them when they were by numbering, and made the tribes of Israel dwell in the tents. Yet they tempted and rebelled against the Most High God, and did not keep his testimonies, but turned back and acted treacherously like the fathers. They turned aside like a treacherous bow, for they provoked him with the high places and bounced his jealousy with the golden images. When God heard, he was filled with wrath and greatly abhorred Israel, so that he abandoned the dwelling place as Shiloh, the tent which he had pitched among them, and gave his strength to captivity and his body into the hand of the adversary. He also delivered his people to the sword, and was filled with wrath at his inheritance. Fire devoured his young men, and his servants had no bread and stones. His knees fell by the sword, and his widows could not weep. Then the Lord awoke as if from sleep, like a warrior overcome by wine. He drove his adversaries backward. He put on them an everlasting reproach. He also rejected the tents of Joseph, and did not choose the tribe of Ephraim, but chose the tribe of Judea, Mount Zion, which he loved. And he built his sanctuary like the heights, like the earth, which he had founded forever. He also chose David his servant, and took him from the sheepfolds, from the care of the ewes, with suckling lambs. He brought him to shepherd Jacob his people, and Israel his inheritance. So he shepherded them according to the integrity of his heart, and guided them with his skillful hands. Psalm 78, peace.